Yo, what up, Cuba?
Yo, man. Hey, yo, hold me down real quick, kid. Niggas wanna fucking front, you know what I'm saying? Ooh. Hey, yo, let's do this, baby.
Let's do it,
go around the corner.
One-on-one?
Let's
go toe to toe. Any stupid ass can blast a foe. Now let me know who's man enough to go toe to toe. Somebody let me know who's not afraid to go blow for blow and show how real niggas really roll. Yo, niggas know not the front. I can knock a chump out the box and just thump. Fuck a Glock a pump. So pop the trunk and grab your 38. I'll snap your fucking vertebrae. And at your early date into the pearly gates. My murder rate is phenomenal. What I'ma do is crush your abdominals. Say the talk for Donahue. This I promise you. Big Punisher. Got to keep it real.
It's not the money, it's a culture.
Is it art?
I love you, Poppy.
Is it vandalism? That's part of the reason why today many graffiti artists stay underground. The very illegality of graffiti making that forced it into the shadows also added to its intrigue and growing base of followers. The question of space and ownership is central to graffiti's history. Its contemporary evolution has gone hand in hand with counterculture scenes. While these movements raised their anti-establishment voices, graffiti artists likewise challenged established boundaries of public property. They reclaimed subway cars, billboards, and even once went so far as to paint an elephant in the city zoo.
Still, I won't want to stop.